Hi, I'm Andrew Wasson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for tuning in to another one of my guitar lessons. This time around, we're going to go to Vancouver, Canada to answer a question that was sent in from Josh. He wrote in saying, my improvisation ability feels like it has hit a plateau that I can't get it moving beyond. My scales are all memorized, but it feels like everything I'm playing is way too scale-like. What can I do to stop everything I play from sounding like scales? Well, thanks a lot, Josh, for writing in. You know, what you're going through is a very common complaint of beginning improvisers. And for any player experiencing this type of problem with scales, there is actually a simple solution. For instance, as an exercise, don't play more than three or four scale tones in the same direction. Instead, play in different directions. Create interval skips, both small and large, and do as many things to break up the scale as possible. Now, to give you a better idea on how this all can work, let's zoom in closer into the guitar neck and go over a few ways that you can get started with creating more contrast with your scales. Well, there's certainly no magic bullet which will get players going on achieving that gravitational pull into really good active tones during improvisation. That, unfortunately, will take many hours of practice and, of course, listening to those artists that you admire. And, you know, there would also need to be time spent working on learning all of those artists' traits and their habits, because that will be a huge part of understanding their style. Now, any player who wants to move into building interesting lines that occur at sharper angles during improvisation can do this by studying a few simple steps. Now, number one, I've got a line here that's in A minor, and it sits in position on the neck and breaks up the effect of the scale by way of interval skips, and there's small skips and large ones here. So let's just start off by finding out what this example sounds like. Here it is, example number one. You can tell there's some bigger skips there. And you just have to get used to them. It takes practice to skip over strings if you're not used to it, but it certainly brings about a very cool sound, gives you some good sharp angles in your improvisation. Now let's move along next into example number two. In this example, I've organized a very lateral approach in B minor, and it goes along the guitar neck, all across the neck really. It uses slides mostly to connect several sections of different scale patterns. Now this idea travels kind of position by position, and it produces a very wide sounding scale line effect. So you do have to know your patterns fairly well to create these, but they're very effective. So let's check out example number two. Okay, very cool ideas. It just takes time to map out all the various scale shapes across the neck to do those. Now, in example number three, I've chopped up the scale even further by mixing both arpeggio and pentatonic concepts in the key of G minor. Now, to use this approach, you'll need to make some further study of your arpeggios if you haven't done so already. But let's move on to just hearing what this sounds like. Starts in third position, goes like this. Playing through diatonic scales in a very straightforward ascending and descending way tends to be the approach that most players take in the beginning. Now, there's nothing wrong with this until you perhaps begin feeling that it's frustrating you and you'd like to gain another approach to your improvising method. See, using only consecutive stepwise motion, albeit common and at times useful, is of course limiting if you're looking for alternative movements for a nice contrast. You know, creating a balance between very consecutive tonal movement and lines that adjust tones at very sharp angles will result in a dramatic effect by breaking up melodies while you're doing your improvising. Anyway, once again, thanks for watching. Have fun working on this stuff. You can download the handout and an MP3 jam track for this lesson over at my website at andrewwasson.com. And you can follow me on Twitter, through Facebook, and on my other guitar blog, YouTube channel. All the links are in the description box below for you. Take care, everybody, and we'll see you next time. Bye for now.